Joining me today is Carolyn Clark, one of our former post-bac pre-medical students on the path to a career in medicine. And Carolyn is now down in the Boston area at Dana-Farber in the oncology unit, doing a clinical research coordinator for the oncology unit at Dana-Farber. And as you were just telling me, Carolyn, you're not quite in yet because of COVID, but let's back up a little bit. Tell me about the position that you just moved, I believe, down to Boston. Tell me about the position that you're starting and hopefully going to kick off soon.
Yeah, so I accepted a position at Dana-Farber as a clinical research coordinator, as you said, in mid-March. And so in that position, my job is to help roll out studies that we're doing, so clinical trials. So I'll be spending a significant amount of time in clinic after we are done dealing with COVID. And so in the meantime, I've been familiarizing myself with the studies, you know, taking care of my online trainings and getting to know my team. We've done a few, you know, virtual happy hours and doing a Grubhub lunch. So I've been very impressed with the way that they've handled me onboarding remotely. So I still very much feel like a part of the team. And I mean, definitely looking forward to going back into the office, but I definitely feel like I'm occupied. Like today I have a data abstraction project that I'm working on. So just working on preparing a list of people that we'll be trying to recruit from for a study. So that's an example, I feel like, of the kind of work that I'll be doing.
That sounds really great. And tell me what else are you doing? Are you preparing for your MCAT? What are some other things that you're doing that are furthering you along towards your health career?
So I took the MCAT in January, so I'm all done with that, which is very exciting. I'm applying this cycle, so I was applying with the committee letter process this year, and so I'll be submitting applications within about a month or so.
That's really exciting. What are you hoping to do? Are you looking to go into MD or PA? What are you hoping to do?
Pre-MD. And it's really exciting to be doing clinical research right now because I would love to be an MD that teaches and also participates in research. I have a mentor at the University of Vermont, Dr. Maruti, who is the director of their addiction program. And it was really exciting to me to get to follow someone who has my dream job. So watching him conduct innovative research and also teach students and then also be a phenomenal clinician, like that's exactly what I want to do. So I really see this current job as preparing me for the clinical research aspect of my future MD career.
I think it's also really great to hear from our folks who are done with the program and so close to entering medical school or dental or whatever folks are moving towards. What advice might you give to some of the post-bacs that are still in it and transitioning to remote learning?
I mean, I think that one of the most important things for me as a post-bac student was to maintain my focus on school. And when challenges come my way, to kind of roll with the punches as much as possible. I think when you start catastrophizing, like nothing gets done. And I think it's important to focus on, okay, at the end of the day, I just need to get a certain grade, you know, or at the end of the day, I need to have a certain amount of volunteering. But I think with COVID in mind, I mean, schools are going to be very understanding if there are, you know, gaps. And I would hope that any post-bac students who might have gaps in service or work or whatever, or maybe lab time, will maybe not worry so much about that because all other pre-med students who are currently in school are in the same boat, you know? So I think focusing on like your health right now, focusing on, you know, when you're feeling overwhelmed, like taking a step back and remembering I have these few concrete goals and these are what I'm trying to achieve, I think would be the most helpful thing for me if I was still in the program at this time.